coronavirus. Let's talk to Dan Weinberger, who's an epidemiologist at the Yale School of Public Health. Thank you very much for joining us. Now, you think that the real figure could be even higher. Why?
That's right. There's been a lot of question about the reliability of the reported death numbers. So we've been looking at just the total number of people who have died in the United States over the past 6 months compared to the same period in previous years. And we see that the numbers are substantially higher than 200,000 already, tens of thousands of deaths more that are not being captured in the official death statistics.
Right. And you use the excess deaths to come to your conclusions. Just tell us how reliable you believe that to be.
Right. There's going to be issues with any approach. And so, you know, these increases that we see above the typical levels of deaths are going to be influenced both by deaths that are directly caused by coronavirus, as well as due to people avoiding healthcare and not going to the emergency room if they have a heart attack, for instance. But we could also see decreases in other causes of death. We might see decreases in other infections and things like car accidents because people were driving less during the lockdown in the spring. So there are a number of different factors that play into this, but overall, you know, the total number of people who have been affected by the pandemic is certainly much higher than the sort of reported tolls.
And how do you see the picture vary between U.S. states and between countries? What are you seeing in the figures?
Yeah, I mean, we've seen tremendously different impacts. New York City has been tremendously hard hit in the spring, and, you know, they were among the hardest hit places in the world. But they were able to bring the epidemic under control. And really much of the northeastern part of the U.S. has been in good shape for the last several months, whereas some states in the south and the west that reopened quite quickly in the spring saw a surge in the summer. But even those states that opened later were not necessarily as hard hit as New York City, where we have this really closely packed population and people with a lot of underlying health issues. So we see tremendous variation between states, between regions. There are parts of the U.S., you know, rural parts of the upper Midwest that really have not seen much of an impact of the pandemic until recently. So they've been largely spared compared to what we've seen in other parts of the country. But if you look at what we see in New York, I think it's comparable to some of the hard-hit areas in Europe and Asia, and whereas other parts of the U.S. have, again, been relatively untouched.
And Dan Weinberger, just briefly, if you will, if you're saying that you think it's more like 250,000 in the U.S., what do you make of the global figures? I mean, do you think that they would be more reliably calculated by excess deaths than by testing, for example?
Yeah, I mean, testing varies quite a bit between countries, as does sort of how countries record deaths and record causes of death. So these sort of excess death approaches are really, I think, the most reliable way to compare impact between locations and between countries.
Dan Weinberger, Associate Professor of Epidemiology at Yale and leading researcher on the U.S. excess deaths. Thank you very much indeed for your time joining us there from the United States.